Hi guys, I'm Sysadmin FK. In previous lecture, what we had did it, we have installed ESXi server and we had configured, we have created DNS entry, I have shown you how you can create a DNS entry, then we have configured the IP address and all, we have tested the network is communicating with DNS or not, then we have configured ISXi server, then we have configured ISXi storage to the ESXi server and we have seen we are able to access the ESXi storage from the web console of ESXi. In a fifth lecture, we are going to install an vCenter server, because without the vCenter server, you cannot manage and you will get many more things from the vCenter server. There are multiple things you can do. vMotion, you can migrate your virtual machine, running virtual machine from one host to another host. For this, you have to configure the vCenter server. So how you can configure the vCenter server? For the configuration of vCenter server, first you have to download the vCenter server ISO, which is available on the VMware side. You can go the site, type on the Google is PCSA6.7 appliance ISO, enter, then you will get the first link where download PCSA appliance. Okay, then if you don't have a account, you have to create your account. If you have account, just log in and download it from here. After downloading, you have to copy to the Windows machine, which is accessible to all your ESXi, and your storage should access that virtual, that Windows machine. After copying on this, I have copied this here, just right click and mount it. It will get mounted. Then you have to go to the VCSA UI installer, then you have to Win32, and here you will get the installer, which is application. You just double click on it, so you will get pop-up. There are four options. I'll show you. Yes, there is four options. First, if you are installing first time, then you go for the install. If you have your current installation 6.5 or 6.70, then you go for the upgrade. If you have your vCenter on Windows machine, then you go for the migrate. If due to some reason your vCenter got crashed, but you have your taken backup of configuration of vCenter, you can go for the restoration. For this, you need an FTP or an FSO, which is configured while configuration of appliance. So we'll go for the install first. We'll just click on it, install. We'll go for the next, and then accept the license. We'll go next. There is two type of deployment. First, there are two types of deployment I shown you. So first is embedded, and second is external. If you have about within 100 ESXi, then you go for the embedded. If you have more than 100, you have multiple PSPs, you have multiple branches which are from one country to another, then you go for the external PSP. So it's better to go with the Windows embedded. So I'm, for the testing purpose, I'm going with embedded. But in now you know the ESXi 7 comes, vCenter 7 came. So in this, they have removed the external PSP. So we'll give the IP address of that ESXi who has at least 2 CPU, means apart from the ESXi needed, if ESXi needed 2 CPU, so you have at least on this server 6 to 7 CPUs, then you can assign 2 CPU to the ESX vCenter. You should have accessible about 300 GB of hard disk for this installation, and you need at least 8 to 12 GB of RAM on that ESXi, except for the ESXi, means ESXi needs 8 GB. Plus this is 8 GB or 8 to 12, so about 20 to 24 GB of RAM should have the ESXi. So my ESXi has about 20 GB of RAM and 16 CPU, so I'm using that. So if you are upgrading, then you will type the vCenter IP address. So root, and this is the password. While installation, we had provided a password. That password it is. So it's done. We'll just go for the next. We'll just click on next. Accept the certificate. It will validate the username and the password is matching or not. If it is validated, we'll go for the further. Otherwise, it will prompt you to retype the password. we'll wait till it validates. Yes, everything is correct. Then we'll give the name as admin Ira. This is the name I have given. This is the password for the root. You should remember this password because resetting of this password is tedious. So it's better to note it down. So we'll go for the 10 environment. It needs 10 GB of RAM, 2 CPUs, and 300 GB of hard disk minimum for the 10 hosts and 100 VMs. So for the testing purpose, is enough for me. So I'm going with the 10. If you can see your production environment, how much needed, and you, according to that, you can select. So we'll go to the next. So see, my 0.2 is having only 8 GB. So we'll just check one. So instead of 2, we'll provide the IP address of 3, which is having 16 CPU and 20 GB of RAM. So what we do, we'll just go to our Windows machine. We'll just go here. Storage. Yes, what we do, we'll just go back. And instead of this, we'll just give the IP address, the username and password is same for me. So I will validate it again. So it's validating. See, that type of error will come if you don't have sufficient parameter required for the vCenter installation. So now it is same. No need to do for the next. Now I'll put next, it will go. So what we'll go with the compute storage, we'll enable the thing, but in production environment, always keep it as a thick. For the purpose of training, I'm showing you thing. So you just provide the fully qualified name. It should be registered with DNS. Otherwise, you will get a problem. So this is the IP. Then I'll give the subnet mask and then the gateway 172.16.0.1 and the DNS also the same. Okay, then we'll go next. You can see here 0.3 VGSXI, VM name is admin era, vCenter with embedded platform service controller, deployment is skinny. Storage type default and data store is computer storage and it is this mode is thin. Network is VM network, IPv4, IP address is 16.0.15, admin era.admin.local, subnet mask 26565, default gateway is 16.0.1, DNS is 172.16.0.1, port and everything is safe. So we'll just go for the finish. So this process needs at least 30 minutes to complete. So in the meantime, I'm going to pause the video for the moment it gets completed. So as it gets 1 or 2%, I'll pause the video, and as it gets completed, I'll back with the video. So failed to connect to the server installer log file located at cadmin.addmin.local located at cuseradminadam.appdata. There came problem occurred during installation. So I'll pause the video and I'll resolve this issue, then I'll back with it. Hi guys, you can see there was some network problem was there. So due to that, the error was coming. So now I have resolved all the issues. So you can see now our deployment has been started. So again, I'm pausing the video and will back as it gets completed. So till time, I'm pausing video. I'll wait for this. So just we'll do pause. Hi guys, so first step has been completed. We'll go for the next step. just continue. So we'll get for the next step where we'll configure the VPSA username and the password, and we'll enable the SSH also. We'll wait till the next step comes. Yes, it's loading. Yes, see, we will go for the next step. So we'll enable SSH here. And if you have NTP IP, you can put it. If you have NTP IP, you can put it separately. Otherwise, you will sync with the SSH host. So we'll go for the next. Chance synchronization SSH saving is done. Then it will ask you the if you have existing SSH, then you can join. If you want, you can create new. So I'm creating new because I'm doing first time. Okay, then local password. This password you should remember because resetting is tedious. So instead of resetting, just keep remember and put it somewhere. You join the customer experience improvement program. You can see now everything is same. Admin era, admin local, 16.15. 2.0.0, 16.0, synchronize with the host. Let's finish and we'll do OK. And this will take now again the time. So it would take at least 1 hour. At least 1 hour it requires. So as it starts, I'll again pause the video and we'll back as it gets completed. So it hasn't started, so we'll wait till it gets completed. So again, I'll pause the video. So, hi guys, you can see now the vCenter has been installed. So now when we close it, we are going to log in to the vCenter server. So we'll just wait. Yes. Now we'll go for the next. We'll launch the web client. VSphere client. Not we'll go for the web client. We'll just go for the VSphere client. So we'll wait. We'll get the page where we log in. And then we'll stop this video. In the next video, I'll show you how you can create a data center and add on host to data center. So we'll wait till the page comes. So it's coming. Yes, we are getting the login page. We got the login page. Admin is writer at vSphere.local, then password. Yes, begin with username and the password. It is a default. You can say this is the power user used to manage all the vSphere infra. So page coming. Yes, you can see we are just click on host and a cluster. Sorry guys, it was a connection with my VPN, so what I'm connecting with VPN, so I'll go with the host and cluster. So I'll refresh one page, so I'll be getting the proper page. So guys, you can see we have installed a vCenter server. Now in the next lecture, I'll show you how you can add a host and how you can create a data center and add a host into the vCenter. So for this, we'll stop and we'll meet in the next lecture. Thank you.